guys, Taser here. I'm back with a new video of Cities Skylines. And yeah, we're looking at a time lapse right now, and I'm building a rail yard in the town Keyport, which we have worked a little bit on. It is pretty close to the rest stop. And yeah, so I'm doing a rail yard over here. And I think this rail yard turned out pretty good. So we have this little cargo station over there, which is a custom one. So yeah, and it actually fits pretty well in there. So yeah, I have taken some inspiration from Palaido Bay, which is a town in GTA 5, because I think that town is pretty cool. And yeah, I just played a little bit of GTA like a week ago, and I just looked at that town and I thought it was pretty cool. So I got some inspiration from it, and like one of the inspirations is to have this like train yard over here and have some like factories pretty like close to it, and then just have a road, and on the other side just have some commercial. So yeah, and some just small bits of detail around this little town from Palaido Bay. So yeah, I thought it was pretty cool to actually get some inspiration from like another video game. And yeah, I really like GTA 5, so it was pretty cool to like look at that town and get inspiration. But yeah, so I'm putting down some concrete here using the what is it called? Surface painter. Yeah, so that is pretty cool. And I'm also doing these fences over here along the train tracks, because I would imagine that there would be some like fences to just cover up so people don't walk over the train tracks. And I'm also using some decals over here. One of them are the like water decal, which looks like some puddles on the ground. And yeah, I really like that one. It just makes the like whole ground feel a lot more realistic, and I definitely like it. So yeah, and I'm also doing this little road which goes up here in this mountain. Or I guess it's not really a mountain over here where the road is, but it is like about to be a mountain. So I'm building that road, and I think it turned out pretty good. I didn't really want to just make a straight road which just goes up pretty boring on the mountain. So I thought I would make a kind of bendy road up there, make it look a little bit interesting. And I think it would be pretty cool when we have cars going on it. So my plan is to have that road leading to another town, which is gonna be a little bit away from Keyport, but still pretty close. So the train track is going to continue over to that town, and I think that is gonna be pretty cool. So yeah, we'll have cargo trains just going through Keyports, and I think that is gonna be nice. And I'm also putting down these train props over here at the train yard, of course, to just make the train yard look a lot more realistic. And yeah, I'm using these American wagons, and they are pretty cool. So yeah, I'm just going about here and plopping them down. But I wanted to just talk a little bit quick about one thing, and that is actually that you should go and follow me on Twitter, because if you are like wondering when a video comes up, and yeah, I just want to ask some question or something, Twitter is a great place for that. I know a lot of people say that in their videos that you should go and follow them and things like that, but to be honest, it is a really good way. I'm also posting like random things just on my Twitter, like things I do. And yeah, for example, this weekend I went and like plane spotted in Copenhagen, which was pretty cool. So yeah, I just posted some pictures over there of some cool planes, and yeah, just some random stuff. And I would like to see some more people just interacting over there on Twitter. So yeah, there will definitely be there's always a link in the description to my Twitter, or it's just called Here Taser. So yeah, if you're interested in that, go and follow me on Twitter and we can have a chat or something. So yeah, I just wanted to get that off. And yeah, so I put down this coal power plant. I think, I'm pretty sure it's called that. So I don't know if it is like oversized for this town, but I mean, I still think it looks pretty cool because like it is a very huge building, so yeah, but I mean, I think it looks pretty cool. So yeah, I wanted to have some like industrial building and stuff like that over there. And yeah, I have also shown some industrial buildings, which you maybe have seen. So yeah, those are quite alright, but something I don't really like with them. I don't really know how I will fix that, but like they look a little bit too modern for this whole place. So yeah, and the reason for that is because from start they look pretty good, but when they upgrade, they just look a little bit too like modern. So yeah, I don't know how I will do about that, but I would want to get some like other industry buildings, but yeah, for now they will be good enough. So yeah, but I'm doing some like parkings, which I just went and did something else, like putting down trees here. But yeah, I did some parking over there outside the cargo station, because I thought it was a little bit empty there on the concrete, and I thought it was a good idea to put down some parking over there and some trees and bushes. So I definitely got happy with that. And I also put down this sauna, which is actually a pretty cool building. So I used it over here. And I also put down this like horror cafe building, which also have some like other stores in it, I think, but it is mainly horror cafe. And I thought that building like fitted pretty well along these like other industrial buildings. So yeah, I think it looks really good and good. I mean, so yeah, that building is a very nice building, and I'm actually happy that I found that one. So yeah, and I'm also like I'm going with this design with these trees, and I don't know, I think it's a really good design to just make the area look a little bit more interesting. It is definitely a good thing to do in like parking lots, just like if you have some space left with some just open concrete, you can definitely do that over there, and it just makes everything look a little bit better. And over here you can see me placing fences manual. So I wanted to use the prop line tool, but as you can see here, I can't really get it to work. So yeah, I don't know, like I'm still not very good at the prop line tool. So yeah, I'm trying to figure it out here, but I wasn't really able to do it. So yeah, I thought like, who cares, I'll just go ahead and place them manually. But yeah, I am not really good at that mod, because I haven't really understood yet how to use it. But I guess I might understand it in the future, I don't know. But like, it is a little bit complicated, but I mean, not really, if you use it in like some kinds of spots. But like sometimes just won't like place the fence, which is really annoying. So yeah, I'm for some reason I'm just going over, yeah, it was because I found this sign over here. So yeah, I'm going over to the harbor just randomly over there, because I found a sign on the Steam Workshop which like said like cargo harbor on it. And when I was scrolling through this like prop menu over here, when I wanted to find the car props, I just found that one. So I thought I'd just go ahead and place it a little bit over in the Chester area. But yeah, I'm using these DHL trucks and the other orange trucks, which I don't know what they're called, but yeah, they're really cool. I have seen Strictoaster using those orange vans, so yeah, I thought I would also download them because they look pretty cool. And yeah, I'm definitely really happy with it. So I'm doing some little thing here on the like wall of this building, just putting down some fallen leaves, and then just putting some small bushes over there. So I mean, that is a pretty good like way to just make everything look a little bit more interesting than just having a normal just wall. So I'm doing this in some kinds of places, not everywhere, but I think I've done it somewhere else as well. So yeah, but that is a pretty good way to just make it look more interesting. And now I'm going about and putting down some like parking lots and some cars, and then this time lapse is almost finished. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed it. I will just leave you with some music for this last bit over here. But yeah, I will see you pretty soon in the live commentary. Okay, so we are here in Keyport, which this town is called, and we're looking over the rail yard, which I made in the time lapse, and I'm pretty happy with it. And I also want to show a little bit more in detail what I've done around here, and yeah, just show a little bit more, because I have done quite a lot of detail. So yeah, let's just hear. We are over here in Keyport, which this town is called, as I said. But yeah, so we have this train yard over here. And I put down some trains, and you're seeing quite a lot of this in the time lapse. But yeah, and I also did quite a lot of like lighting over here. And that actually looks pretty cool in the night. And something I also did was to put some fence over here, because before I put that down, there were no fence, so it just looked a little bit weird when it was just open over there. And now we have that fence over there, which I think looks a lot more realistic, so that is pretty good. And yeah, so we have this place over here. We have this sauna, which you can see a little bit here. There's a guy just sitting over there. But yeah, we have this sauna over there, and then we have this car parking, which is like a car parking for the like town center. And we also have this pretty cool Hard Rock Cafe building, which I think suits pretty well over here. And we also have this little like alley, which just has like some cars, or I guess they are vans. We have some DHL and some, like, I don't know that name, but yeah, those look pretty cool. And I'm actually really happy with this alley. So yeah, a little tip you can do to make stuff like this look a little bit better is that you can put down these like small grass plants. I don't really know what they are called, but yeah, and also just put some like fallen leaves or this like decal, and just put them like over here at the wall, and it just makes it look a lot more realistic, and I think it looks really cool. Also used this decals over here, or actually just one, or no, there is actually quite a lot. Have some like cracks in the ground, and we also have this like no parking zone. And yeah, I am actually really happy with this alley. And yeah, I also did just some small details over here, some like industrial props. I put down these cars just standing over here. I didn't want to like fill up the whole car parking, because I would imagine that there was just there would just be like some cars just standing over here, nothing too special. And then I also put this fence, which goes like this, just to, like, to cover off the tracks. Because I mean, that is a little bit more realistic than just have it open, because I mean, there will be like freight trains going here, and otherwise it will be probably a bit dangerous. And I think I'm gonna continue it over here, but I haven't really touched this area, not here either. And yeah, but I will get to this place, but I don't really know what to do over here, but I will come up with that, and I think I will just continue this fence here. But yeah, so I did this this little like hill with all these like trees and bushes and all sort of cool things. So yeah, we have this place over here, which I'm actually really happy with. And we have like some decals, we have this like grass decal, and we also have just a lot of bushes. And this is something I took inspiration from Grand Theft Auto 5, Palito Bay, which, like, I have taken quite a lot of inspiration from that town in Keyport. So yeah, that is basically where the like whole idea with this train yard comes from, because I thought like it would look pretty cool to have some nice train yard over here. And yeah, so and we also put down this tower, which I said I got inspiration from, because there is actually like some water tower over there as well. And I do really like how that looks. It fits in very well, so yeah, I'm definitely happy with it. And we also have some decals, and I also used these like new trees. They're probably not new, but for me they are new. Like I just downloaded them. So yeah, they're pretty cool. I mean, they're pretty cool. So yeah, I used them. And just put down some bushes around here. And I used these like rocks, which like they aren't these ones, but they're like some like smaller rocks. I don't really know, but they make the area look really good. So and also we have just continue this little like theme with these trees over here, and it looks really good. And we have these like big ones, which I do like as well. And I think it will be really cool if we will have some freight trains over here. The reason I'm saying if we maybe will have some freight trains is that I haven't really come up with any idea of what I'm gonna do over here. But probably a new town or something, which this train track is gonna lead to. So yeah, I think we will have trains going over there. So. And then also this little gravel road, and I don't know why I had to do that, but just annoyed me that tree was in the middle of the road, or not really middle, but alright, so we have this little house over here, which I kind of thought would look pretty cool to just put down in this little, I guess it's a small forest. And yeah, we just have this house there, and we have this little, like, I don't know what this is, but I just think it makes the area look pretty cool. Just have this little, like, garbage, I guess, and this little abandoned car, and yeah, I don't know. I thought it was a little bit empty here, so I thought it was a good idea to do something cool there. And also used these old power lines, just going along this gravel road, because I thought they will fit pretty good. They will maybe extend out here to another town in the future. I don't really know yet, but they will definitely come to some use later on, I think so. And also I did this road, which goes here. And I am happy with that. And what I'm gonna do with this road is also continue it out here to some town probably. Or just get it up in the mountains. We'll have to see that, but I do like how this looks when it just curves like that, because I mean, I could do a, like, I could make the road just going up like that, but I think this looks really cool, just have it that bendy. And yeah, it looks pretty cool from above as well. And yeah, we have this like industrial place over here, where we have the like cargo station, which is a custom one. I don't really know what is it called, I mean, it fits very good, so I'm definitely happy with it. And I just put down some props over here. We have these vans again, and some containers, some trailers, DHL vans, some tanks, and just a lot of decals here on the ground, because I would imagine that it will be kinda dirty in an area like this, because I mean, you would have a lot of trucks going in, dropping off stuff. And yeah, just to make it look a lot nicer, and I definitely think it looks very good to have those decals over there. And just a little bit of more decals like that over here, and I'm pretty sure I didn't know these ones are in this asset, so yeah. But this parking isn't in the asset, as you saw, because that truck just went through it, but I'm not gonna change that, because I think this parking turned out very good, because otherwise it was just open here. But I wanted to add a parking lot for these cars, and I think it looks good. So yeah, we also have this parking lot over here, which is a little bit bigger, and yeah, we have quite a lot of cars standing there. And then if we go, or we have like this big plant, I don't know what it is, but I mean, it's, I can just check here. Yeah, it's a coal power plant, so I thought that would fit pretty good. Maybe it's a little bit oversized, but I mean, I don't know. I think it looks cool. And just some garbage like facility over there. And then just come over here, we have these trees, and like almost the same as over there. So just detail a little bit over here, and left some like more open space here, and then just a little bit more detail here. And we have also this farm over here. Which I think looks really good. I have some trees just like that. It's meant to like look like some farm thing over here. But yeah, I think it looks nice. And we have some a little house as well there. And I think this is a water tower, which is a little bit more rural. And I definitely like how that looks up there. So yeah, and that is basically what I've done, I think. I mean, I have done some work in this area over here, which is like the center of Keyport. But yeah, I'm pretty sure I have showed you quite a lot of this. I don't know if I showed you this one, like the Taco Bell thing. It was actually quite a while ago since I did this, but yeah, I think it looks good. I have some fence around here and just some cars, and I think it looks nice. And I'm pretty sure that should be it. I don't know if I did anymore. Just trying to think here. No, I'm pretty sure I didn't do anymore. So yeah, this is what I've done, and I hope you like it. I like it a lot, so yeah, I'm definitely happy with it. Okay, so in this episode I thought I will basically just finish up this whole town of Keyport. Just like finish up like areas like this and just detail quite a lot, even though I won't really detail here around these houses. Probably put quite a lot of trees and stuff over here. And yeah, I also added a police station over here, so yeah. But that is basically what I want to do in this episode. Just like fill up this whole town, make it look finished, as well as over here, and definitely out like beside this church, because now it just looks like a little bit too empty. So yeah, I would definitely do something here. And I'm I kind of thought about making something cool here by the water, but I don't really know what I want to do. I could use where are they? Probably in here. I could use some of these ones. I can actually check how they look. I mean, that is not terrible. I can't use the node editor for this one. So yeah. But yeah, I think this thing over here. What is it? It is a... I can't click on it. Okay. But yeah, it is a marina. Alright. So I think I want to put some of these over here. Just a little bit like this, have some like path going here, and yeah, just make it like a cool waterfront area. I don't think I want to use a key over here, because I think that would look a little bit too urban, because I mean, this is just a small town, so yeah, I don't know. Okay, so this is the progress I've done so far. I have added some like some of these trees over here. I don't know what they're called, but yeah, and we also have, of course, these ones. And yeah, we have just this little like waterfront walk over here, which I'm actually really happy with. And I use this little like concrete road, which I do like, but I don't know if I should like change it to one of these ones, like maybe this one with bikes. But that one is a little bit too big, so probably not. But no, to be honest, I actually think I like this one, so yeah. But this is how it looks. I thought I would like want some fences over here, but I mean, to be honest, we like this is enough to just have these trees over here, because I mean, you don't really need to have fences over here. So yeah, I think this is definitely good. We have some like jet skis, we have some boats, and yeah, and I also added some like house over here, and these roads, like this one comes down here and then goes up and connects to this road over here. And I also put down quite a lot of trees between the houses, and I do think that looks pretty good. And we have some water over here, because I kind of lowered the water over here, because it was like getting up on this road and things like that, and it wasn't very good. So yeah, that is the reason why there are water here, but I think it will clear out pretty soon, hopefully. So yeah, This like is not really finished yet. I do want to do some stuff over here. So what I thought I want to do is to put down some rocks, like these ones, rock area. Okay, so they are called rock area. Good to know. And I guess I could just do some of them or put down some of them just a little bit here. Something like that. And this one, I don't know, I don't really like this one. Like, I kind of like the like small gaps between those. So yeah, I don't really like that one, but these ones I do definitely like. And basically when I do my details, I just go ahead and put trees like on these ones. Then just put some like bushes between them, maybe do some decals. Like, I really enjoy the decal mod and like the decal assets. Like, they are really good. Just makes it look so much more realistic to have like some dirt on the ground and have like water. And yeah, just really nice. And yeah, so I use these like normal trees with leaves, and then these, what are they called? Alright, so pine tree. I use these ones as well. Just a little bit random placed over here. And I don't want to put more of these oaks over here. So I think I will go ahead and find some bushes. So these ones are like my favorite, but I still like these ones a lot. They are also pretty good. So just a little bit like this, and it doesn't have to be too much detail, just a little bit like that, and something like that. That I think is pretty good. Maybe a little bit down there, a little bit here, and I think that is pretty good. Like that, maybe could get one of these ones. Like that, and I should probably get some parkings over here. So they are in here. Let's just see. There we have them. So this is probably going up, or no, it isn't. So that is good, which means that I could place it perfect over here, hopefully. Yeah, just like that. Just another one there. And now just put some concrete. Something like that, and the same over there. I mean, it doesn't really have to be perfect. So yeah, I think that is definitely fine. I think I would just have one parking over here. Could have a like disabled lot as well. And then just put this concrete brush over there. I don't know if I... Alright, so, I mean, we could just put some, like, bushes here, and I think it would look a little bit nicer. So get some of these, like that. Probably this one there. Like that. A little bit there. And also here. So, like, down there. And I could also use this tree, which I do like. Yeah, I do like how that looks, and probably one there as well. And now I just want to find some car props, which should be here. Yes, they are. So I don't really want to have too many cars, so I could just get one there, could get this one, and then I also could get that one like there. These decals are really nice. So yeah, I especially like this one, which like has the grass. I think that one looks really good. And yeah, I thought I would just place them a little bit like that. And that is pretty good. So yeah, we have this little waterfront over here, which I, oh my god, I really like this. Looks really cool, actually. My question is if we should get some light. Could be a pretty good idea. Maybe some more like textures over here. I could get this one just coming out from that rock, like that. Yeah, I do like that. And as well as there, probably here too. and then like that there, and maybe up here. Yeah, that looks good. Definitely not that one. Could get some cracks in the concrete over there, and yeah, let's just see. Some light could be pretty good. Let's just make it nighttime. I don't know if you can see very good here, but you will hopefully soon when we put down some street lights. So not taxiway lights, because this is not a airport. Not that one. I want a yellow one. Not that one, but no, wait, where is the other one? I know there is like a normal street light. Yeah, this one, which is yellow. Or maybe not. No, I think I would go with the white one. Yeah, I think that looks pretty good. Also here by the parking makes sense. And then just continue them over here. Because this area would be definitely lit up. I'm pretty sure about that. Just continue them like this. Question is if we could get like one yellow light over here. Like that, and then just continue the white ones to up to here, and like that. Like I don't know if I like placing the lamps myself, because it is pretty convenient to have them placed automatic by the road. But like I kinda enjoy doing this as well, because it is actually pretty fun to just put them down by yourself, because you can really decide exactly where you want them. Maybe I should change to have them on this side now. Yeah, why not? So let's get some of them here. Maybe get one yellow. Why not? So there, then like there, by this house, and one more there, maybe here as well, because this is a little bit dark here, like that. Right, so that looks pretty good. I really like how this town looks in the night. It looks really cool, and you just have the trains coming, and yeah, it just looks really cool. And yeah, I'm gonna go into the daytime now. So yeah, we have put down some street lights, which is good. So this area should be pretty lit enough by the night. So yeah, I don't really know what I want to do here. Maybe I'll just leave it, or I'll probably do something. I mean, could just get some bushes just a little bit here by this like street lamp, like this. Could get a tree here as well. Like one bush there, and just a little bit here, so something like that. Can use this tree over there, and there as well. And like, I don't really think I want to do more than that. I could get some like decals. I don't know which one I should get. Maybe this one. Yeah, maybe, no, I don't want it to go on the bridge. Just like that. Maybe going out from there as well. And yeah, I think this is pretty good, because I mean, I kind of want to have this space pretty open, because I mean, we have a lot of space covered by trees. So it could be pretty cool to have like some space open so you can actually see something. But yeah, so something that I also like with this area over here with the like boats and stuff like that is that it is pretty realistic, because it would be like much less realistic to have it here or something, even though I probably wouldn't have it here. But yeah, because you would have like all the waves coming in, but this like highway, highway terrain over here covers it up pretty well. So yeah, and like it would be pretty cool to have some like boat props in this little river, like some small boats. But by small boats, I don't really mean like these ones. I mean a little bit bigger. I guess like they could be called river boats. I don't know if they are called that, but yeah, Could be pretty cool to have some of those. I'm pretty sure there aren't anyone on the or anyone's on the workshop, but I could look. But I'm pretty certain there aren't any. So yeah, but I think I want to go in the next episode and like put down a bus depot over here in the Chester area and get some public transport in, probably connect up the train station to Keyport, and yeah, just connect everything with some public transport, and I think that could be really good. But yeah, I think we have done pretty good progress in this episode. We have done this little waterfront area, which I'm really happy with. I think it looks very good. I do like that we have some cars standing over here, and that guy is actually a big douchebag. maybe not, to be honest, because if he isn't like disabled, would kind of make sense to park there, because he wouldn't be able to park there. But I don't know. He could just park over here, but I mean, it is his business. I don't really care. But yeah, so I'm definitely happy with it. I hope you enjoyed it as well. Probably just do some. I will probably do some stuff off camera, just some really small details and things like that around here. But for now, I think this is pretty good. I also did some trees over here, which I didn't show, but yeah, it's nothing special. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to leave a like, and if you're new to the channel, make sure to subscribe, and yeah, I will catch you next time. Take care, guys, and have a great day. Bye bye.